Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Civil Engineering Academy. My name's Cody. Let's go ahead and get started. So today we have a project management problem. This is going to be a quantity takeoff method, and basically we're trying to find the total cost for a concrete line ditch paving section. So let's go ahead and read the problem. It says a concrete line ditch paving section is shown below. It is 600 feet long, has a uniform thickness of 6 inches. With a 5% waste, the material costs for the concrete and the curing compound are $100 per cubic yard and $50 per gallon, respectively. Specifications state the curing compound must be applied at a rate of 1 gallon for every 250 square yards. What is most nearly the total material cost? So this is a very simple problem. You just got to think your way through it. So what I advise for this problem is to split it up into three sections. We can find the areas for these three sections. So here's going to be a cut. So this is going to be section one. And then we can make a cut here. We can call this section two, section three, okay? So now we have to find the areas and the volumes for each section. And then just multiply by our cost per that unit. So let's go ahead and find the area of one. So area of one, right? We need to, we know that the height is 20. We're kind of given a picture, something like this. And we have a 3-to-1 slope. So that's three, that's one. And we know that this is 20 feet. So we can use this to our advantage. We can multiply 20 feet times our 3-to-1 ratio. And you end up with 60 feet being your X. So that is this distance here. Okay, and we know that this distance is 20. So this is 20, this is 60, all right? So now we need to find this guy. So what is that? We need to do 20 squared plus 60 squared. We're doing the Pythagorean theorem here. Square root that. You end up with 63.25, and that's going to be feet. It is in linear feet. So we need that to find our area of the surface area of our concrete. Let's go ahead and scroll down here. Okay, so we found our length for that hypotenuse. Now we need to multiply it by the depth. The problem says it's 600 feet long in length, so that means we're going to have to do 63.25 feet times our 600 feet. Times our 600 feet. That's a 6. And that will give you an area of 37950 feet squared. Okay, so that's your area 1. So this is area 1. And if you look at the problem, we notice that area 1 and area 3 are identical. So we can set those equal to each other. We know that area 1 and area 3 is going to be the exact same. So let's go ahead and make that statement here. Area 1 is equal to area 3. Good deal. So that means that that is equal to 37950 square feet. Good. So now we need to find the volume. Volume of 1 is equal to the volume of 3 because remember they're identical. You're going to do 37950 square feet. And we're going to multiply that by our thickness, which if you remember from the problem is a half a foot. 6 inches is half a foot. And we need it in feet so that way our units jive. So whenever you do that, you end up with 18975. And that's going to be cubic feet for each, for V1 and V2. So now it's time to find our area in for two, A2. This one is just a flat one. It's going to be 20 feet wide and 600 feet in depth. So this one's a pretty easy one. 20 feet times 600 feet. And that guy ends up being 12,000 square feet. Let's go ahead and find our volume for 2. V2 is equal to 12,000 square feet times your thickness, so 0.5 feet. Good deal. That ends up with 6,000 cubic feet. Okay. So now what we need to do is we need to add up our volumes, add up our areas, and ultimately take into account that waste factor. The reason why we have to do our areas and our volumes is because if you remember from the problem, it talks about, you know, you're going to have a gallon for every, you know, 250 square yards. So we need to use that, and we need the volume here. So we have it in feet. We need to make sure that we convert it over to yards whenever we do this. So let's go ahead and find our total area. So that is area 1 plus area 2 plus area 3. And that ends up being 87,900 square feet. Okay, so let's go ahead and find our volume total. And that is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. And that ends up being 43,950 cubic feet. Or if you look at this, the area total times a half a foot in thickness gives you your volume. So that's another shortcut. You really didn't have to go through the process of finding V1, V2, V3. You can just find your area, multiply it by thickness. Boom, there you go. So let's go ahead and convert. We need to convert this to square yards, and we need to convert this to cubic yards. So the way you do that is for your square feet, you have 9 square feet for every square yard. So you divide this by 9, and I ended up with 9766.67 square yards. Okay, and then for this guy, if you divide it by 27,1627.78 cubic yards. Very nice. So now we need to take into our account our waste factor. So the problem states that we have a 5% waste. So we've taken into account our length, we've taken into account our thickness. We need to take into account this waste. Okay, so for waste, let's go ahead and label that. You're going to do your area total times your 1.05, and you're going to do your volume total times 1.05 square yards. So solving for our new total volume, when you multiply that by your waste factor, I ended up with 1709.17, and that is cubic yards. So now we can go ahead and get started with our cost. So the curing compound, we'll go ahead and start with that. So for the curing compound, it says that it is 1 gallon for every 250 square yards and $50 per gallon. So let's do that. Let's just write this down. So let's just write this down. It says 1 gallon for every 250 square yards. And then it says it was $50 a gallon. Okay. So let's scoot up so that way we can see our area here. We end up with 10255 square yards. I don't know if you're familiar with the train tracks method, but here we go. I'm about to teach you. You have 1 gallon for every 250 square yards. And then we have $50 per gallon. So by doing this, you can see that the yards cancel, the gallons cancel, and we're left with the dollar signs. So after that, after you do that math, you should end up with $2,051. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the let's go ahead and do the concrete now. Concrete. And you're gonna take, let's check the price tag here. It says it was $100 per cubic yard. So $100 per cubic yard. Good to know. Our volume, our total volume was 1709.17 cubic yards. Let's do our train tracks again. You have a cubic yard over $100, and that will give you 170917. I just moved the decimal point. It's 100. So there's your new price tag for your concrete. And we need to add these guys up, and that will give us our total material cost. Okay, so our total cost is equal to 2051 plus 170917, and that gives you an answer of172968. So there's your answer. So I hope this helps, and we'll catch you next time.